Oh.
We need a substitute, Lester.
No, no, I won't be able to read my. There we go.
Commas. I don't even have a paper in my.
It's not so old, no one else was.
I'll take notes of this disagreement. And then you guys take over.
You can take notes here.
Oh, that's yours.
Perfect.
I would suggest a roll call.
Wait, all right, so who's second?
Well, you just motion to open the meeting, you don't first check the meeting.
Okay.
They just motion to open the meeting. At 7:05.
7:05.
And then I would take a roll call, because it's not normal. Always.
Well, it is pretty much.
Yeah.
Kelly.
Roll call.
Lester.
Kathy.
I win.
Shanna.
Jody.
Kate.
Did everybody get one of these, or no?
Yeah, I think I did, we had them last Wednesday. They got a shovel.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, so I guess I'm first. So, over the last week, well, actually, Jody, when did we interview Brittany? I don't remember.
We have?
Because we appointed her on Monday.
Okay.
So we did offer Brittany the assistant director position, and she has accepted. So, we have our first hire.
Yay.
Did she apply for the assistant or the director?
Assistant, well, actually, she kind of.
She just applied.
Yeah, she applied.
She said, here, I want to work there.
Yeah.
She said assistant director or councilman.
Yeah, so.
Oh, okay.
I think worst case scenario, though, if we can't find a director, I think she'd be fine.
Yeah.
She'd be great.
Is she assertive?
Well, that was my.
That was why you went with assistant?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And she's young still, you know, so I'd like to see, and I know Roxanne.
She's not going to be like assertive enough for it. She's really soft. I worked with her. She's good, and she'd be able to do it, but she's soft. And she, I don't know if she'd be able to be on the counselor's like forms. And I think she would be kind of better as an assistant, but.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't know if we've taken that.
But I do know a girl that works there as well, that would rock at it. I sent her a message, she hasn't got back to me yet.
And Brittany, one of the reasons too, she's graduating from college in May and with a dual degree in elementary education and dance education. So the first thing that, and I don't even know if we did, first thing I thought was like, oh, so, and she sent in a thing about the science experiments. I was like, oh, science time with Brittany, dance time with Brittany. Yep, got on schedule already, so.
Swim time with Kelly.
I think the other positive aspect is the fact that she's known in that grade school.
Yeah. And she was actually substitute teaching Thursday and Friday of this past week.
Does she work there, Brittany, at the grade school?
Her mom works there. Yeah.
That's a lot, in the kindergarten for a while.
She's run a couple of what I consider the Kaleidoscope programs after the dance programs my kids took, you know, they love her. They know who she is, they're so excited to hear that she's coming.
Yes, yes, yeah.
So, yeah, a lot of kids will know her.
Yeah.
Which I think is another reason why we felt important to get it out there quickly, so that parents know who it is that's coming in, and they know her and trust her, and could see the type of person that we're looking for now.
Did we have any other applicants?
We had the other girl who I knew from swimming, who had been 3 years at the works. She has a little bit of a snafu with her schedule. She has to do, she's doing an internship this summer, and found out that that internship won't end until after our first week of camp, so.
So she would miss the first week?
Yes, which, you know, isn't awful, but it is.
It's not a good start.
Yes, exactly.
That's the first week.
Right, so I kind of was like, so we thought, actually, that night, we were going to interview both of them for the assistant director position, and then I kind of told told the girl that I know, Molly, I was like, yeah, you know, kind of missing the first week is a little tough. So, you know, maybe you want to apply for a counselor position and that we might be able to, you know, I don't know what she's going to do for work. But she was a little younger. She's going into her junior year at college, too. So, you know, Brittany has the degree coming in May, so I thought that was...
So how many counselor applications do we have?
How many? We've only had one, I think, right?
Well, that we've received. We've had a few people ask, how do I get the application? How do I look what the job description is? Whether or not we got some in the mail?
No, I don't know.
Okay.
One. Camp counselor, we got one.
Is that the first that we've actually received?
This is the first one I've actually seen.
I stopped in on Friday and picked up whatever she had.
Did she have applications?
Yes. Where did I put that? There's...
We actually have 10.
No, we had one other one, but it was for the assistant director position. So we need to talk to this girl. I don't know if Jordan, you might know her. Girl from Sligo Road. What was her name? I have it somewhere.
I remember seeing it. Did she?
She contacted us first.
Isabel.
Yes.
Isabel.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
right.
She's finishing her.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good. See, and yeah, we did get her resume. I have it somewhere. So she was looking at the assistant director position. So. We basically need to get back to her and ask her if she'd be interested in our counselor position. And I was just at a swim meet today, and there's a girl that on deck who's coaching, I know through swimming, and I said, oh, did you pick your major yet at UNH? Yes, my major is recreation management at UNH. And I said, are you looking for a job for this summer? And she's like, yeah, I might be. And so then, I didn't even think about the work study because I said, oh, we're paying, you know, like $8.50 or whatever a night. So I just sent her a message and I said, you know, we're actually applying for a work study option for you. So
yeah.
Do we know what the status is of that?
I sent it in whatever election it was, Thursday. So I sent it in on Thursday and so that was...
So it goes to, you sent it to UNH, correct?
Yes.
And then they...
The financial director, blah blah blah.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Let me check my sent box. Yeah, she hasn't sent anything back, so I'll have to call her.
But I don't know how the process works with that. Do you, that they get back to you? I
call her kind of,
yeah.
In the morning with questions on how to fill it out. We filled it out, sent it in, and then I called her later in the day to make sure she received it, and I got voicemail. I said, oh, apparently they leave by 3.
Yeah. College. And we did apply for, what did we write down, 2 to 6?
2 to 6 counselors.
Yeah, so.
They can't take the director role because in the application it says that they need a Zoom. So I was like, oh. But that also opens up the window for if counselors are paid by us by half of the money, then that leaves more money for us for the counselors.
Yeah.
So I thought that was great. So I added. Few more. Actually, you happened to run in while I was filling out the application. I'm like, what do you think?
You?
She's like, beautiful.
Yeah, ask.
More.
So, better. So yeah, I guess that's kind of where we are. So the feelers are out. I had a contact over at who graduated from recreation management from UNH, sent her our camp director position, and she posted it on their recreation management and policy Facebook page, which is a private page that has apparently hundreds of people that have graduated with that degree that looks at job stuff. So, you know, hopefully we'll post more people in. I think the, you know, finding that director right now is important.
The girl I was thinking of from UNH is going for her master's. She has a classroom next fall. So she wants the summer to get it ready.
So she's She'll be bored all summer getting her up. Tell she needs some.
I don't know how long does that take?
About 2 hours for me. I'm in high school, so I don't need as many bells and whistles.
Paper, pens, good, let's roll. Where's my red pen?
That'll take 2 hours of mine. Yep, so that's where we are. So still moving.
So as far as Brittany's concerned, we did do an offer letter that's going to have to, went over to the select board and Carolyn to take a look at. Dan, I'm going to give this to you to...
Sure.
Correct.
Yeah, and so this is why I'm wearing it. It's going to be in color, but that's going to go up on Facebook as soon as I get it done. Again, it's going to go to Dan. I'm going to have to take a look at it. But it's the announcement that's going to go on Facebook, just to announce Brittany's coming on board. So if I can get Dan to... So Lester brought up a really great question before he came here that we can discuss as part of the staff and applicant hiring.
Today. Good question.
I'm going to write that down.
Yeah.
Days? 3/26.
You also had a question today. I'm supposed to remind you of that. I handed you the registration for Jen Pepin and the t-shirt
Thank you.
Money.
Thank you.
You got a registration?
She got a
couple. Actually, I talked to her over Facebook or
Jen
email. Is it Jen Pepin, is that? Yeah, I talked to her over.
Yeah, and your t-shirt.
Yes, yeah, so Lester brought up a good question about the applicants that are coming in. And he's wondering about, does the committee have the, can we vet out like the applicants to make sure that we're not getting folks from last year? So I don't know how we want to do that. I don't know if we want to get the applicants in and then review it every 2 weeks, or I don't know how we want to handle that. But I think it's a great point, because I wouldn't even know if a stack of applicants is somebody from last year. I don't know any of them.
Right. Well,
so
I hope that they would have put that on there.
That's correct.
Yeah.
I don't even know all their names either.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure she can regurgitate a list.
Well, people has it.
Okay,
but,
so we have to.
I know Lauren French, Josie's brother, older brother, left there.
And I don't, like
See,
I said,
she wrote on her past employment camp counselor. I would like to think that if anybody's on there, that.
Well, and if we found out that they were prior counselor and didn't put it on there, well, they're out just for falsifying their.
Right.
But I think they would.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
as you get the applicants in, email the committee. So we got an applicant in, and the interview will be on whatever.
My understanding with that, they have been younger. Like, Jordan, were you with the older ones, the older camp counselors last year?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm thinking that anybody from last year were more 16, 17-year-olds at this point, which will need 3 letters of recommendation, correct?
Yep.
So.
And my concern wasn't necessarily just about people that worked here last year, because I can't say for sure if all of them were or weren't competent, but was just in general.
Right.
Because if you have a personal experience where Jimmy volunteered to help assist swimming and he was, no way, he almost drowned a kid on purpose or whatever, okay, well, you know, that's something we should know.
So maybe
well, you now have an assistant director that has input, who also worked there last year.
And is she going to be involved in the interviews then?
She should be in the emails.
Yes.
In the emails, but I mean she's in college right now, so
if she can't make the interview, yes, but she should be involved in the emails because they are going to be reporting to her and the director.
True.
And
until we get a director, she's it.
She worked there before, right?
She was there last year.
She was very part-time, though, last year. I think she was one of the 10-hour-a-week, maybe.
As a
counselor? Yes.
Yes, she was a counselor, and she stepped up because of the disorganization. And when we presented what this committee had done, she loved everything we have done.
Yeah.
We're doing the walkie-talkies, the schedule, she even put sunscreen on. She was very happy with everything that we have done. And she had great ideas too.
Yeah.
So. But yes, include her on the emails when you send them out.
So then applicants will all get emails to the rec committee and then we can just add any input. or thoughts or suggested questions.
Yeah. Suggested questions would go to one of them if they're going to be interviewing without me. Mm-hmm. The board has said, if you guys want to interview, that's fine. Send the recommendation to the board,
okay.
Then we
yep.
hire.
I sent you that email, didn't I?
You're
I don't know. Probably.
Okay.
Oh,
good. I'm not feeling so bad. Good. Well, just keep reading.
Oh, no, it's in red.
Okay. Perfect. All right.
It's just bad because he's doing a lot of writing in the margins.
Yeah, that's good.
All right, so anything else for applicants and hiring? Yeah, Malmsted. D, you want to take
okay.
over camper registration? That might be quick.
So as of today, we have two. We've got two. Now, did you grab one from Carolyn? She had one that was mailed to her.
I guess. Recently?
Yeah.
Oh, because I, the one that had the receipt on top?
I don't know. But yeah, probably.
Okay.
Do you have that?
I didn't give that to you.
No. All right, so two. I know that we have two. What I can tell you is that there's been a lot of chatter, though. I've had some emails come in. I did send out, well, part of the next bucket, anyways, is I sent out an email to all last year's parents and just told them about the new program and asked for their feedback. And I did get three people who, out of 61, who actually did reply back to me, too, were like, I can't wait, my girls are going to love it. So there was that. And there was one woman who came back and wasn't very happy about the tuition hike. But my message back to her was sort of like, you know, you get what you pay for, pretty much. You know, last year you got what you paid for, this year you're going to get what you paid for. Somebody said it in a better
way
than that.
I mean, you could take
any
kids somewhere else, but it's going to cost more than this.
Right. Yeah, that's right. I broke it down for her, you know. And I didn't hear back from her, but that's fine, you know. I made no excuses. It was just, this is what it is, and that's what you got, you know. One of the two women, though, was very happy to open up a dialogue with me about why it's how she felt about it last year, and we all feel the same, and she's happy to see it's changed, and she was debating between this one and the new market rec, and I told her, well, this is why she should come here, and that's it, so let's see what happens.
How many registrations do we have so far?
Two that have been mailed.
Well, you have
Jen's, well, two that
we'll
I would actually have in my hand today, like
she gave you mine and Jen's.
Okay, so three.
And then
that's her Jazz teacher.
That's yeah, and that was actually one of my questions is that a parent dropped him off at the school.
Oh.
Apparently one of the drop offs is the school, which
yeah.
I did not remember or realize.
Yeah, it was in the
but what they're doing is the registrations are out in boxes, the mailboxes. And there's a Manel folder to put your registration in.
Oh.
So somebody has to get there every single day because now we have money sitting at the school.
So
who is going to do that?
Every.
Look at us. Yeah, I said the same thing when I phoned out. So we might have a winner.
So they were going to tell me if they had any at all.
At the end of the day.
I would not trust that because that's the last thing on their mind. Somebody has to be able to pick that up. So do
does
we want somebody
else to do that? Does your wife pick up your kids every day?
Where would I bring it?
I should know this. No, they take the bus home. 2 second bus ride.
Roxanne, let me take the bus.
Yeah. I can't get there every day, but.
Or it has to not be at the school. Because they can't drop
that.
It off at the school.
Maybe we should just have it dropped off here.
Right.
How do we switch that if it's already out there?
Yeah, it's already
registration.
Out there.
I think we just deal with going there and next year we can.
So Roxanne,
please email who you get or that you got three or whatever if they're sealed because you
and
can't open it.
Right.
Because once you open it, you're responsible for what's in it. So,
all right, let's
some see. People are dropping off
cash.
Yeah,
oh.
Like we opened one and it was cash.
I'm
like,
the first one we got was cash.
Oh
was
my!
Like, oh, that's interesting.
I don't want $500 sitting around. So she signed it, I signed it, we brought it to Caroline right away. We're like, deposit it.
We're like, take this away from us.
That was
don't
move
the
receipt,
envelope.
Right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
So Caroline wrote the receipt and stapled it to the application. So when I find it, I'll give it to you.
So I can bring it to the town hall the next morning, maybe?
Yes.
I
well, if I get them anyways. I might as well just go get them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because they're going to come today, so I'll just figure it out. Before I go to work, I'll just go to the school.
Or every other day or something, but if they're sitting there a week, Megan dropped hers off on, the parent dropped hers off on Monday.
There's always
Yeah.
I mean, you could always call Caroline every day at like 2:45 and say, did you get any today? And then you don't have to go. There isn't any sitting there, right?
Who's Caroline?
So let's see, so we got 10 plus 2.
Alright.
So marketing, so there was a woman who's at the town meeting who takes the notes, and she was telling me that she handles the Facebook page for Summersworth, what's happening. And she actually had contacted me about volunteering her skill set, which is painting, watercolor painting. And then she told me she did this Facebook page, so I sent her all our information. And she's going to post on her Facebook page for Summersworth, which is great. So that was one of the things that happened. The other one was the emails to parents. And I've just been running around hanging up flyers. So just word of mouth, word of mouth. Keep talking, keep doing it.
Keep repost it.
Yep. Yeah, because I found it somewhere taken down.
If you could repost everything.
Yeah.
No, she's talking about Facebook. I mean, talking about media and stuff. You're talking like regular.
Oh, I was talking about regular flyers. Just
putting
going down.
Oh, yeah.
Physically,
yeah.
The old-fashioned one.
So Facebook, yeah. Facebook should be like a continual, like,
yeah,
posting
you
something
continually
no matter what it is.
Something like on yours to yours to yours to yours to yours. And repost that, hey, they're looking for donations for water and playground balls and jump ropes and chalk and whatever. Please bring to town hall and drop it off. It'll get on my desk and we'll have it. So, but if we keep that up.
Could we maybe talk about, you know, with the Facebook page, maybe like a schedule? Because I know like I opened up the Facebook page, but I don't really know what I should be, you know, I haven't really posted anything. You guys have posted everything. But I am more than willing to post things. I just don't really know what to post. So I mean, if you want some sort of schedule, you know, to upload how often you want to post things or what exactly you're trying to do. I'm just saying I'm willing to
just
help out and post things.
Yeah.
I just don't really know what to post.
Yeah, just word of mouth. Like, put it on that site and then take it from that site to
like your personal
to my personal site. And then I share it, and then she shares it, and then you share it, and then you share it, and then you share it, and so on and so on and so on. So,
I think what I was saying is just like the original post, like, you know, I know you've seen a bunch, but just
right, because you want
sorts of things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And every week we'll have.
I mean, everybody taking turns, sort of like.
Yeah.
So I think this week I just put out like a minion comic. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just put it out there just to keep it going, just to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's the whole idea, right?
Yeah.
Just to keep.
Yeah, just keep it going. Right?
Yeah, sure.
I know what you're saying about the schedule lines.
I just don't, you know, if there are certain things that we want to get out there.
Yeah.
You know, just say I'm more than willing to post. I just don't want.
Maybe like the early bird registration, 30, you know, bus lab, stuff like that.
Yeah, things like that. That's a good idea. That
all right, let me think about that then, and then we'll come up with some sort of.
Maybe a list of things that we want. That's a good start.
Yeah,
like,
so we want,
know,
we definitely want to get out communication about who we hire. We definitely want that, the new hire postings. We'll definitely want to hire, post about donations. We want to post about the camp continually, like, don't forget, I'm so wasted.
Right.
It's cold out, but summer's coming. Things like that. So,
one of the other things that was questioned was. For aftercare. It says per week. Is that due, and do they need to tell you right away at the beginning of the year, or do they need to and pay for it up front, or is it a week?
We decided to do that up front, right?
Yes.
And I think, didn't we put that in registration?
It's in the registration, and it's a one-box check.
I know, I didn't.
So if it was an old registration, then it, no, didn't we snag that, Dee, before they went out?
Well, what if someone doesn't need it at first, and then they all of a sudden do, if there's availability, can they then?
Sure, there's availability.
Pay all of it at once and for the rest of the summer? Or what if they only need it like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday?
No.
It's the same thing for the whole week.
Yeah, but.
They could use it.
They specify.
So all pre and post-camp care to be prepaid for entire summer. And then there's another page in here that tells that racks off which.
Which, they can make, they can choose between pre or post or both, but it's kind of an all or nothing.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
If that was the only option we gave, you can choose just morning or just afternoon or both.
And does it, is there a spot that, I haven't looked at in a while, is there a spot that says which weeks?
No.
Nope.
So that's the question.
That's what we took out.
Yep. That's what we took out.
Because we're not giving options of weeks.
It was too complicated.
We're not giving options of weeks, though, it's the whole summer.
No, it says per child per week.
Right, but isn't it per child per week, so you have to figure out how many.
If you're doing pre or post.
Yeah, but what if you only did it for 4 weeks out of the summer?
Right.
You're going on vacation for two, I mean.
They're not gonna be there.
You want that spot open for someone else?
No, we weren't gonna do that. We talked about that. Lester brought that up the last time.
So that's where they got confused.
Yeah.
I said I will remind the board.
So I guess maybe on the registration, we should have said.
For future reference.
Right.
So, but yes, it has to be.
The whatever it is, what is that to?
Tell us what weeks you're gonna need and whatever weeks they are, you have to prepay at the beginning. Correct?
Yes, 15 times 8 would be 120, right?
Yeah, so I'm gonna be paying $30 a day times two. I'll be paying $60 a day for the pre and post. $15 for the morning per child per week.
Yes.
So I have two, so that's $30. And then pre and post is $15 a week per child per week. $30, so that's $60 a day for before and after care.
Right, so it'd be $240 for the pre and post for one child.
Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. You get a discount?
You guys haven't said anything. Let me know.
Let's move on.
Yeah.
All right, so we're done there. Budget. You're next.
I'm next. All right. As far as I know, we have $38, but I have some questions because I know we talked about money from last year that shouldn't have been in a private account somewhere, but was in a private account somewhere, and or we thought there was. Do we have?
It's gone.
Somewhere?
It's gone.
Okay.
It's in general fund.
Okay,
yeah,
so that's gone. That's fine. I just didn't know. And then we had the fundraiser at Town Hall Day. What money did we get made from that?
So you should have sent you that information. Should
I got
that
it.
On.
I just don't remember.
She did send.
I sent you my account, too.
And your pizza went over big, by the way. Thank you very much.
That was huge.
I heard,
Lester, I don't
like,
have it with me.
There wasn't enough. I guess it went nuts.
Well, see, I didn't know how. I didn't want to overbuy. So I was like,
great.
Look, here, I'm doing.
You made a lot of friends that day.
I figured I had to leave. That would keep some people that need my stay. But I had to go. I had a team waiting for me.
All right, so Coach Lester, I sent you my Gmail the other day that had my totals on it. I have to go back and find it. So I can't tell you off the top of my head what it was. And then I think Celia might have sent you how much you sold in shirts.
Well, now, yeah, I got an email about the shirts.
There should have been shirt money, cash money, pizza money.
Yep.
And then just a donation bucket.
Mm-hmm. and she had all
included
that
in the
left.
Donation was the coffee slash donut money.
Yep. And I don't remember how much that was. You know,
it was
pretty.
Yeah.
It was like 58 for.
Because I know I bought two shirts.
I think it was 58 in shirts, and then it was 20 or 30. I don't know.
It was like 60.
Anyways, if that's okay, I can just resend it to you when I find it. I can do that. So
donation
is
103.23.
Oh, you got it?
No, I don't have
any. What was
the
single
fake?
I sent it. It was Saturday or Sunday. Right?
17, 18.
From you?
Yeah.
Did you send it all?
Yes.
318?
Should have. 103.23.
Oh, that's one.
But it was.
Okay.
Is the distribution, let's say, everybody, is everybody on that?
Maybe they should be.
Lester?
The distribution list on that.
X?
You can.
I only
Wall
see.
What was the title?
Town meeting, something like that.
So it
would
have been the 16?
Okay, 103.23.
I don't know.
The total.
Saturday, Thursday.
What was it?
103.23. We received a total of $80 in orders for t-shirts.
Wait, 103.23? Mm-hmm. Oh, 23 cents. Oh, because they had, you could donate.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay.
And then
maybe
in t-shirts?
Yeah.
So that's $80.
And then we got $80 in shirts?
No, I don't know how many Jen got over that. Do not get it?
I don't
see
it.
If you search
Thank
your
you.
Inbox and put in donations, it comes up. That's what I had to look for because I had so many.
Jody said the rep made $38 in donations today at voting.
Yeah.
I sent that one.
And we're still sitting in your box.
Okay. So Noah sent it out and I had some people reply back to me.
Okay,
find it.
So so far we have $38 in donations, and then we have 103.23, and then we have $80 that we've collected for shirts. And that's all that we have collected at this point.
And who is Mrs. Ackerman?
She
would like to donate. Doesn't have
email. Somebody
anonymously.
Was
anonymously.
Celia.
Celia,
wasn't somebody getting into anonymously?
Yes. Sorry. All I know is that Celia was going to get in touch with that very kind person.
So that's where we stand at this point. That's all the information I have. I don't even know if you have cut any checks for buses or anything.
Oh, no. Do we know if Caroline does that? Has sent the check out to the New Hampshire State Parks?
We signed it on Monday.
So how much was that
right.
that we sent
yeah.
out?
Two
something. Oh, these are going to be solid books. Two something.
Two something.
Okay.
I remember it was two something. There it is. It's 10.
Let me check
today.
My
email.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. That went out. All
right. Yes, we signed it.
I'll have to check my junk mail.
So it went out March 18th at 9:42 p.m.
To the whole committee?
Yes. Yeah,
forward it to me again, and I'm gonna check my junk mail. Because I get the.
You didn't let me know that you use the distribution list I'm using, and it's not good.
Yeah,
I wrote down 225 from the last meeting.
225 for the buses.
That sounds.
There
might be two.
Let me check.
I
guess I did.
It was 225, but it might have been $10 registration fee.
Oh, I'm sorry, was it for the New Hampshire State Park?
Uh-huh.
But that was for the parks or for buses?
That is the same, I believe. But that's
park entry.
It's a
that's
park
the park entry fee. So that's not paying for the bus to drive there. That's,
no.
Okay.
That
so
is a separate.
Okay.
But
that
as
would
we
be
pay
separate.
That we're all set for the whole.
Yeah.
Thing.
So there's something
okay.
sticky on
this. Purchase order $11.59. Made up for the state of New Hampshire Parks and Rec for $235.
$235.
Yeah.
Okay,
and
so we are.
10 summer of fun state park passes.
So we're good there, and I forget, do we also have to pay for this swimming, or we're paying that per trip when we do it kind of thing? We have to worry about
that now. I don't know if it's per trip, and I'll have to, it must be per trip, because it's actually per person, so they'll have to count. So I don't know how we'll do that at that time.
You'll have a purchase, you can set up a purchase order ahead of time. They need to know what you're going to be spending. What you don't want to do is spend the money and then be reimbursed above and beyond a couple $100. They kind of like get cranky about that. So you just put in a purchase order that we're going to be paying whoever, Dover Pool or whatever, for possibility of up to $300 or $500 or whatever it is.
Yeah.
And then $3, so it might be $150. Yeah. So if you, they could give us, you're going to have to pay per person when you get there?
I think that's how they're running it. I'll talk to him again. Let me,
okay. So, and then your bus should be a flat rate because you know what date you're going to be getting your bus.
Right.
The bus, so that'll be a purchase
set.
Order too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you'll need a purchase order for the bus, you'll need a purchase order for the pool. You will have incidental that you'll be reimbursed for, and that'll just have to be worked out somehow. I'm sure that's going to come up.
So we have to meet with Caroline in some time this week, so we'll bring up how can we keep track money-wise with the purchase orders and make sure that you get told how much the purchase order is being opened for and what we're posting against that purchase order. We'll come up with some sort of system.
Well, I'll just email everybody that we signed a purchase order tonight for blah, 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 because you're going to be submitting it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's not going to be a problem, and I can just email you as it's happening.
Okay, and then put the number in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, because as you guys are going to decide, like, okay, it's going to cost so much for the buses, here's our purchase order.
Right. Do you have, you're the contact for that, for the
for
bus.
For now, yeah.
Yeah. So maybe, I don't know how far in advance we need, didn't they sell you 2 weeks, right? 2 weeks for
buses? Yeah, I was hoping mid-May, though, we'd be able to get our schedule.
Yeah.
But so I'll, when I see Caroline this week, I'll ask her about if we have that purchase order.
Okay.
Sounds good.
All right.
Were we still going to set up something at the bank sale that's not happening? It's the ice cream social now.
So there is that official? There is no penny sale?
The penny sale is officially not happening.
That's going to take the place of it. So. And it's this week?
It's
Thursday.
That was a pretty
good thing. No, it's April 30th. April 30th is when we're doing it.
April 30th
for the ice cream social.
Is that down at the Legion also?
Oh, right.
Yep, we are still doing it at the Legion on
April 30th
from 1 to 4.
Because that still is early bird specials that day.
Is that the last day of specials?
May 12th.
Oh, that's right. I wanted 30th and 15th. You wanted these funky numbers. That's right. You won that.
1 to 4?
All right.
Where
is it?
Yeah,
the Legion.
That's good to know. We
should
have a table set up.
Okay. And I'll be definitely confirming anything for that one Tuesday with them. Do you guys just need, like, are you just going to need, like, a table like this, or is that sufficient, I think?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we have a size.
We're going to have a life-size Lego man. That would be awesome if we could get someone in a Lego suit. Is that both to you, by the way?
I think he just volunteered.
That would be fun.
Man, I wonder if they rent those.
What day? April 30th.
Is this
Sunday?
So we haven't seen anything that's not official yet.
We're finalizing, hoping to finalize all the details. We had 2 meetings that were snowed out.
Of course.
So,
you'll have her.
Hopefully Tuesday we'll have everything finalized, and if there's anything that changes, I'll just come out.
Is that Saturday or Sunday?
This is Sunday.
Not Thursday.
Not, it's not Thursday.
I had it written on my calendar for Thursday. I'm like, why is it in the school day?
What is Saturday?
And I think that's when they want the basket stuff or something.
Mm.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it just reminded me I need to get stuff from that.
So that was all that I had.
Okay. Celia had the t-shirt update. I can tell you, Kristen contacted me though, and she saw the quality of the gray shirts. She said they're much softer than she anticipated. So they're a good quality shirt, but that's all I know. Celia's not here to give an update, so I have no idea what's going on there.
She did send an email a few minutes ago.
Yeah.
I got that email.
So I can tell, I mean, I sent all of you guys what happened to DJ, and as much as I hated to send out a second email to be like, I'm sorry, we really need $12.50 from you.
I know.
They were like, okay, we'll do it.
Yes.
So that was pretty awesome.
Yeah.
I know. So, and I don't know if Kristen said, she has a really cute little slogan that she sent. Did you get that one too? Something like, so under their C&J logo, she wants to write something like helping kids go places or something like that, which I was like,
oh,
that's really
yeah.
cute and
yeah.
clever. And I assume we have to pass it by them. But so, yeah, $12.50 done.
That's
awesome.
So add that to your
yeah.
money muster.
And she actually already emailed me and
said,
I have a check waiting.
How much is the check she got?
$12.50. I didn't get it yet, but it's coming. So I can, I can happy to pick that up.
All right, so
I know. So I'm not putting that on the books yet.
No.
I
in the holding pattern.
Well, with that said, I was just reading. So are we not, so is the camp Raleigh Hero now done? Are we done with the camp Raleigh Hero?
I would think so.
Well, what about the whatchamacallits that already offered money? The
anonymous ones.
The anonymous
no,
people?
No, no. The people at the pool company, Portsmouth.
Yes.
Aquas?
Yeah.
I haven't heard back from them, so I would have to, as far as being official, although I think I got something from Simo Electric that he's interested in.
I mean, I don't see, because we already put the feelers out. I'd hate to tell them no, and the next year we need donors, and they're like, well, you blew me off last year.
Right.
What if
well,
you put something on the t-shirt thing already?
No.
So I think Celia's proposal is all about still having the Camp Raleigh Hero out there, just looks like taking off the ability to put your name on the shirt.
I kind of had a thought that maybe we could do, I don't know, I have, because we had some days that we listed under our scheduling, right, as, like you had on the first week, like a ice cream social, right? What if we took some of that sponsor money, you know, and said, barbecue today, or ice cream today, care of
because this
Aqua
like
Paradise Pools, or Simo Electric, right?
That's a great idea.
That's a good idea.
Or you could just buy a vinyl sign, like they do for baseball and softball for $65. Have it up all summer.
Mm-hmm.
Sit on the fence all summer so you can see who's donating to programs.
Yeah.
I think that's a better idea.
Yeah.
I mean, we can take that money and put it towards hamburgers or whatever, and then we can handwrite a sign if they want.
Yeah.
Sounds like a good thing for the camp counselors to make or something with the kids, a project.
Yeah.
And then.
So you're saying the proposal is we keep the $250 and beyond for Camp Raleigh Hero. Not have the name on the shirt.
Yes.
Make a vinyl sign with all the names proudly displayed at the camp.
Like the check-in table.
Yeah.
And right on the front of the table.
That money can go towards, I think she was saying here, special activities.
Well, it can go to whatever
field trips
we
or
need
whatever,
it.
Crafts,
and then,
whatever.
And then when those people do send in their money, just make sure we just keep. Thank you so much to
Simo
Electric for
doing
this year.
And it's
going
to be on a bunch. So I make a motion that we don't put any more names on the back of the t-shirt. And
it does get too busy sometimes on the back of the t-shirt. And like they're trying to find your name.
Yeah. And any further donations will be put on a vinyl sign that we'll purchase and hang.
Second.
There we go. Got it?
Yeah.
That was a lot of wording.
Lester.
So when you say all further, do you mean any other, or do you mean the Camp Raleigh Hero level?
Yes.
Got it. Yes to Camp
Raleigh. Camp Raleigh Hero, the 250, that's what I was trying to get.
Forgetting businesses that
okay.
Wanted to build.
Who's that?
Jody did.
So I think Sue is probably a little bit still a bit too much in here, isn't it?
No, no, the heroes are the business. Those are another name for them. So it's one sign that says, thank you, Team Electric.
We have a private name, but our, I think we had that much of it, but they don't want to be recognized.
Yeah, and
if they want to be recognized, I can get a sign.
Mr. Smith.
But most people don't.
And what is the cost to be at Camp Hero?
$250.
Yes.
And what if, you know how we need easy apps? What if we put them?
We could put it there instead. I mean, we don't have to decide where to put it right now.
Or could we buy, use that money to buy an easy app and then put their name on it?
Well, if you label an easy app, it gets quite expensive.
No, we're just hanging the sign in front of the easy app, like in the back.
Well, you can, but you're going to take that up and down every day. If you've ever been to a tournament, you know what that's like. So you're asking the counselors.
They're young kids. They can do it.
You're asking the counselors to do that every day. And that's another way to do it, because they're going to need shade as the sun moves, too. So that's great. So whatever they... Whatever the directors feel is appropriate, we'll give them designs. They will put where they need.
We have easy apps.
Those the
canopies. No, I'm just like, no, I baked in this.
No,
canopies.
Is that what
you're familiar with? Oh, I was totally lost. Sure.
So, and I'm sorry, this just came to me because we were talking about the canopies or easy apps. Do we have somewhere for them to supply? I guess supply. Put all their stuff like after they leave. Like, are they allowed to put stuff in a room at school?
So
storage, like for all this
was,
stuff. Because last year they didn't have any real stuff to store anywhere. Right?
Well, there was in their little teacher's lounge last year.
So that's something I was going to ask Kate. It's on my list because I think it would be good for us to have some sort of like an office or something where all that stuff can be put, or an area where all that stuff can be put inside.
Right.
Yeah. So I need to ask her. There's still a couple.
Because in the past, they did have, like, those air hockey tables and so forth, like I put in the kindergarten room or whatever, but we're ex-nate all that. So there really isn't anything that was...
I don't know if we still have that stuff.
No one will learn it. I think we talked about that. So...
We could get donations, but I mean, because that was a nice feature of the camp last year.
Did they have a ping pong table in there?
Well, the kindergarten room was just that it had... But I mean, my son like played Risk and Monopoly.
Right,
I loved it. You know, so I mean, just stuff like that.
Which I think we're still gonna. I think we're gonna have that room still.
She hasn't answered me.
She's still on that.
No idea
what.
I hope so.
Me and Katie
will
have
to
play
all
day with
the kids. She's like, "What's the case?"
You did it to me too, and I don't know how to play.
Is there gonna be a full-size fridge and freezer?
No, Mom, you don't play. There was in the kindergarten, but there was one in the teacher's room. So.
There's a bathroom in the kindergarten too.
So I need to find out.
Yeah, that's nice.
We need to find out what part of the schools we can actually use. Can we use kindergarten room?
Well,
we use the kitchen for the refrigerator.
Yeah, what are they redoing this?
It
summer?
Was like
nothing.
The
The electrical power is being done, so I don't know when the gym floor is now going to be done. Our last week of camp.
Okay, so we lose a week.
So we just hope there's not a lot of rain.
But my question to her was, okay, so the gym is closed, that's fine, but what other parts of the school can we use?
Right.
In addition, or just at all, what can we use? But she's not right back to
me. I think that lower area was always kind of camp area.
Yes.
Yeah. Was there a refrigerator in the art room last year?
Yeah.
There was?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's
a full-size one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To me, we don't even need the teacher on the space. Maybe that's...
I'm sure
I'll take it in space with
me. If we add the kindergarten room, then we have people who donate board games and things like that.
Yeah.
We have a board game, then. We could get that.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to get rid of
feature.
Sorry.
You know?
has too much tension around the house. I wouldn't even let the light together.
Yeah, I just stacked the box of funny donations to four games.
Yeah.
Because it's a good option for rainy days.
Puzzles.
Want to get out of the sun.
All my puzzles are missing pieces.
They're pretty much useless after that,
All right. CJ talked about sponsorship.
Mm-hmm.
Anything?
What about sponsoring a child, a camper? What were the prices on that?
It was 120.
Yeah.
120. You can help cover tuition for a camper who would otherwise be unable to participate in the program. And the other one was $30 for sponsor staffer. So $250.
Which at this point, I don't even know if we need that either. We get $12.50 for t-shirts, isn't that?
So if we, I would say this, if we decided to get rid of sponsor staffer, we should still provide maybe a tuition, a sponsor level that's.
We already sent that out, right?
Okay.
Has she sent those out? No.
Why eliminate it? I mean, if someone's going to do it, let them do it. I mean, I'd do 30 before I'd do 120.
Or is sponsor like
just to go toward the water and that kind of stuff? No, well, I was just thinking, we already got the full amount.
It would be $30 for supplies
at this point.
But you still need money to sponsor children.
Right.
So just leave it the
way
it is.
Yeah, I'm like, 1 minute.
No, we were going to give the $30 for the staff t-shirts. That's the one we're talking about. We weren't talking about the other one.
So what will the 30 go towards?
This one's the sponsor staffer.
For the three t-shirts for the staff.
Yeah, that was the $30 level. It was a $250 level, $120 level, and a $30 level. The smallest level is the sponsor staffer's t-shirts.
I think at this point it's like, okay, you know, if you want to donate.
So change it?
We're not changing anything.
But if someone wants to send in $10 just as a donation, we'll take it.
What we will change is the be a camp rally hero. Just change that. I'll have to change that. Maybe not so much more than the words here. I'll take a look at it and get back to it.
Okay, the next thing we have, does Kathy know about that new role?
Yeah. The community service coordinator. What did you come up with?
Yes.
All right.
You know, community service, because I'm not familiar with the gardens, like how that watering, so I need to do more research on that. And I was trying to ask my sons what ideas they had, and like, Mom, you know, what about, like, because we know some elderly people that would like their, you know, shrubs trim, but what if somebody gets hurt doing the shrubs?
Yeah. Well, mommy, what I did today?
Like, you know, the liability. No, this will be like 6th grade through 8th grade, right?
Right.
So,
it can rake,
like, and I can bring them to the church, and like, we have a little flower garden there.
So what if we talk to Tamara to find out if there's any special projects in the library that needs to be taken care of that's not so much high liability or?
Yeah, we can do that.
At what point does this become more the director's job than our job, though?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think we can give them all these ideas and stuff, and sort of say, hey, here's all the information we have. What do you see, and what do you want to do, and make it happen?
Right. I think the only con to that is that if we do hire a director that may not be too familiar with the community, we might have to.
Well, then we can help them.
Yeah.
Well, we've got a bunch of ideas and a lot of contact information.
We do have the cross street walkway.
Okay.
That's part of the garden club. So they need.
Where's
the
cross
street? There used to be a street between
3rd
street,
2nd
street.
It's not very long. It's like, you know,
the walkway, the sidewalk.
Yeah. What about just walking?
Especially
down the
foundry
street,
on
the side there. One of my big,
huge
problems
is
down
there.
My
little kids.
Traffic going on foundry, people pulling down front.
Yeah, you don't know what you're going to pick up.
Yeah,
that's true. You really can't
do
it anymore. As much as we used to do that.
Yeah. do anything these days.
The town doesn't do town cleanup days?
I know.
The town doesn't do town.
There was like a.
The town doesn't, we, the school.
The Legion used to do like a.
It was all part of.
Community cleanup day, whatever.
We have one, and every section has a different part, like last year there was a team that did the upstairs, there was a team that did the crosswalk, but the crosswalk's gonna need weeding.
No.
During the summer.
When the snow all melts, there's one day.
Yeah.
We just, the whole town just picks up trash.
There have been those.
The whole school, when they ask you to send it to class.
Yeah.
Oh, that's an Earth Day, right? Yeah, any from?
I know with like the garden, you mentioned the garden, I mean, most of those plots are like privately owned, like people, you know, buy a plot, so they probably don't want kids to run around. Plot, you know, what's this?
Right.
Tomato plant.
So I guess what I'll do is I'll do some research on projects, and then we can present it to the director and say these are some options you can pick.
Some like trail stuff in Scoutland.
There are those trails in the, you know,
right,
behind the garden.
Trail.
Scoutland.
Beds available?
I'm sorry.
I said the art club. If the garden club doesn't have beds available, I guess we'd have to ask Kate, but we could throw some beds.
We could make some new beds.
In the asphalt area or something, just temporarily for the summer, and then pull them up.
Becky Wright had a bed.
Yes.
Right?
Just for the kindergarten.
Right?
School.
Behind the school?
Yeah.
So.
But I think she brings it down to the garden club too sometimes.
Yeah.
So Becky is the person that we would.
She knows a lot about the garden club. Definitely.
She did with the little.
I think she's part of it.
Becky Wright?
Sure.
Yeah. She did the butterfly area there too, right?
She's done a lot with the trails.
Yes.
The garden club.
Yeah.
The only problem with those trails, there are a lot of ticks back there in the summer. That's the only problem. Which is kind of a big problem.
Sorry, the camp counselors, we can put sunscreen application and tick check.
Tick check.
Are we talking about that animal person that comes and does a show? I don't know if I missed, because I missed that one week.
I think we talked about that as having, if we had some extra money.
Well,
to,
that could be part of that extra $30.
Right, extra day.
Because I saw it, the Parents Magazine that's out everywhere has all the summer camps in it. And there was one of both of those people that do the animals, I forget what it's called, Wildlife.
Well, yeah, Wildlife Adventures or something like that.
What if we, I don't know what you think about the garden, would we be able to purchase a plot and then have the kids grow?
Yeah, probably. These are $20 each. I had one several years ago.
Just for the summer?
So.
That was great.
More than 30, I think.
You can come play with that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice of you.
Yeah, that'd be kind of a cool thing. That could be. Yeah, well, we could have kids who are interested,
child labor, no,
you know, go down there every day and.
Well, we those plants.
So they need watering every day, they go down there.
Yeah. A group of kids could sign up to do that, could be their thing, you know.
You could even put a sign down there. Maybe some of the people, like, I know Chrissy would always walk down with her water, but she works till late, and if the kids are volunteering to water her,
yeah,
she'd probably be into that.
There's a sign.
Yeah.
With
the
phone number on it.
I know, so, well, Becky Wright is, I'm pretty sure, is involved. I think Suzanne, you were just involved in the garden club.
Yes.
Yeah.
She's chair.
Yeah.
Chair, vice chair.
So she's the one, probably.
No, Michelle.
I'd
actually
like
to
Michelle's small. Yeah, okay. That's right.
Suzanne said, nope, talk to Michelle. I said, okay.
Michelle Small is the name.
So if they wanted to purchase, if the rec wanted to purchase a plot, how
there
would
isn't
that?
One available.
Yeah.
And there's a waiting list already.
Oh, okay.
Wow. That's good though.
Oh, so that's
always the case.
That's not
that's
an option.
Just now, it's just this year.
Well, that's why I was saying, if it's okay with Kate, we can build, because it's just one by eights, you know, and dirt.
So Lester, the first Friday of camp, we have an opening for.
You know what? I'm not feeling well that day.
Volunteer.
My dog ate my homework.
Too.
I'd be into that.
I mean, I would have no issue. Now the problem is there's hammers and nails.
Right. Don't give them to my kids. But.
But.
Well, like the adult kind of. Took
well,
control
that would
of
be
the construction, right. And then the kids could put the dirt in and
yeah.
planting.
And I'm sure we could get the dirt probably donated or minimal cost.
What would bring
us that dirt smells real nice.
And we have fertilizer right next door to the school, which I'm sure they donate.
Oh, is that area like behind by the soft golf field, the bleachers are? Then there's like kind of an area back there. I don't know how much sun it gets, but that could be a spot. I don't know.
I mean, it'd be temporary, and
yeah, but we could take it down at the end of the
season. And I don't know if Becky's beds are still up or if anyone.
Yeah, I wonder if she has some vines.
Yeah. So anyway.
Poison ivy.
I'll contact if you
that's for the older.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I mean the younger kids.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
We have
saws. Hour
with the younger kids, and then your city's always going to read.
Power saw stuff.
Sure.
Yeah, I get
it. No, they want your brain to keep going.
Yeah.
So push comes to shove.
Yeah, Jeff could. My husband
could probably do that too.
I think once the wood's cut, then the older sixth grader.
Oh, yeah.
Billy drilling.
Oh, we have so many people.
Yeah, exactly.
Billy Gammon.
Don't use nails.
Yes. Because we're going to take it apart.
Megan, my brother's
doing it.
I'm just throwing that under the bus now. Then what else can we have for a construction project? Sounds like we have tons of stuff.
People want to take it. They want a gazebo.
Build birdhouses and
stuff. Ask Kate if she wants a gazebo.
So we'll work downward.
Let's do it.
Oh my God, my kids would love that.
That's right.
The boys,
they come over to my house and
build
one.
Yeah.
I need a deck, actually.
Wow. So you're going to have the Anderson boys come over and do a deck?
Oh, no. I'm thinking swing rooms up there.
All right. Sounds great. So did you want to talk about
Here's a thought. So and Jody might be able to help with this kind of this thought that I actually was talking to Caroline on Friday, and she's taking a course in a nonprofit organization, and she kind of threw something out at me that we might want to think about, because understanding the budget. So what she told me was our budget line is our budget line, and it doesn't matter. Correct. How much money we raise?
Yes.
So here's the question, and that's why it's hard to not want to raise money if we can, but we cannot overspend our budget line, and it doesn't matter how much money we raise. So
now.
Can I cut you off?
Yeah, absolutely.
Because
I'm
going.
Okay. I'm like. My head is rolling. That
a new book out. Hold on. Fresh and clean.
Yes.
Our rec budget line is $39,577. Okay. So you have supplies, rec transportation, summer rec, winter rec.
That includes winter.
Salaries. Summer rec salaries. So here's the thing: you go over, and if you go under on your salaries, and you raise money, and your line is 39, you're thinking you want to save that money for next year.
Yeah.
But that's not possible right now.
Right.
You don't have a rollover option. So you would have to put that into
you'd have to put that as a presentation on the next voting cycle.
But I guess what I was worried about, like, so say, let's just throw it out there, say we raise $5,000. Technically, we really can't spend that, can we? Because we can't go over this bottom, this 39,000.
So if we end up raising 45,000,
You want to use it this year.
Right.
So
there's almost a reason not to raise a huge amount of money.
No, there is a reason to raise a huge amount of
tell
money.
Me why.
A, you look sustainable.
Yeah.
B, you have winter rec that you may want to put things to.
Right.
So
right now under our line for winter rec, what is that line?
It goes from January to January.
Yeah.
And right now you only have 1,130 for the ice liner.
So you put it in for that?
So could we spend more money for winter rec if we... So say this 1250 that we just pulled in from CNJ, say that's over that. Could we use that for something else besides the summer rec?
You can't...
We're the rec committee, not the summer rec committee.
Right.
You are the rec committee.
But there's no line under winter rec for expenses. Well, there's the 1,100.
There's the 1,100.
Okay.
So say you want to add something else and you have the money to do it, yeah. Whatever you don't use is going to be going back into general fund.
So we just can't save it for next year.
But
we can spend it if we aren't.
So this is where...
But you have to make sure that your salaries are paid.
Right.
So until August, you're...
Right.
Yeah.
So for a point of clarification then, we're on there for 39,577. If we raise 45,000, just to pick a number higher than that, can we spend 45,000 or we can only spend 39,577?
Good question. Okay.
Right.
So
that's
your 39,577 is coming from your registration.
We cannot spend 45, even if
it
raises.
So does it depend where it's coming from?
Thank you.
What was that?
That is correct, what you just said.
So we can raise 200,000, but we can only spend 39,577.
That is correct.
You will be over budget, yes.
But we wouldn't be over budget, we'd be over income.
Your income would go into your anticipated revenues line. So there would be... We'd have to create an anticipated revenues line, which obviously is zero right now.
So, like she just said, so CNJ graciously donates $1,200.
Mm-hmm.
They're donating it to these kids, but in the end, if our income ends up being $2,000 more, say $42,000,
mm-hmm.
then CNJ's donation just went to the town of Rollinsford, spend it on whatever they want.
Yeah, I think that's...
And you don't think the roads are important for the kids?
No, but that's not what they did. I'm not saying that, but what I'm saying is they donated to the kids.
Right, and it paid for the shirts.
But it didn't, because we got the income from the tuition. So, back to my question then. So, if they donate this money, to go
you want to keep it in a revolving fund. That's not going to happen this year. You have to put it into a warrant article to be approved by the voters.
Can we put it into the winter, or does that have
no,
to stay?
No, it's too late. Voting just happened last week.
So that's not.
Well, and that's why this idea is creating possibly creating a non-profit organization like call it Friends of Summer Rec.
Then you're not a town organization any longer.
That's slippery slope.
Okay, rather than money then, why don't we ask for just donations if you can? I mean,
it doesn't matter. It's all under the same.
So
no,
if someone dropped off like a huge box
right.
of like sports equipment, we can't value that.
So can we at the end go back to CNJ and say we're
material,
giving you back your donation?
Yeah,
can you then give us this
thing.
Instead?
It'll all wash out, it's fine. But no, you cannot roll it over yet. You need a revolving fund first.
Why did we miss that?
Because
Never mind, doesn't matter.
It came too close to voting season and it was too late to put on the ballot.
I think we should definitely think about that for future.
Oh, sure, because if we do get extra donations and we want to buy a bouncy house and we have the money to, that'll be great for years to come, but now we can't.
But Joni, didn't you say that, how did you put that? We ended up getting the walkie-talkies because we used some of that 5,000, right?
Yeah, yeah, it came out of, what happened is that your line item,
more.
At the end of the year, come December, we know closely what we got left in our budget, as much as we possibly have.
We, you're talking about as a town?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
So we knew we had, I'm taking a number out of the top of my head, 200,000 left. So we ended up doing this membrane roof. We got the walkie-talkies. We ended up doing the cupola roof out of 2016's budget, which was never supposed to, it wasn't in the budget, but emergency happened. So it came out of, we had the money in the budget, we spent it on what needed to be done. So we made sure that that purchase order came in, I think it was like the last week of December, to make it into the 2016 budget. So.
All right, so there's nothing.
Does that make you feel a little bit better?
No, because I mean, it doesn't matter what I feel, I guess, but I feel it's unethical to ask. And we're assuming that we're going to get more than, which would be a great problem to have, but to have someone, I mean, I'm not going to donate to a specific cause and then find out that they took that money and put it towards something total. No, I'm going to go back and say I want my money back. I would have donated to the roads if I wanted the roads fixed, but I wanted the kids to go to Disneyland or whatever.
Yeah, they don't use it for the shirts or whatever. They're going to use it to send one more kid to camp. Right? We're going to send one more field trip. We're going to, right? That's what you want to do.
Well, no, we're not, because we cannot spend more than $39,577. So we can't take that money and add another field trip. We can't decide to, if we
do like an end of the summer.
If we had an extra $2,000 more than we expected, so we have $42,000, we couldn't spend that extra $2,000 on the kids for an end of year party. We can only spend $39,577.
But if you work your budget right, your salaries, because you're not going to be paying, if you get these work study kids, your salaries are not going to be as high as they are expected. Your expected salary is $37,000.
We can move things around.
So you
move
things around.
We can.
And if we have the food and drink, like a ton of water donated, then we have that.
Right. That comes out of your supply line. You have these five lines to play with. You move them around any way you want.
So people that are coming to us and saying, hey, I want to make a financial donation, we're better off saying, instead of a financial donation, we need an air hockey table. You wanted to donate $250. There's an air hockey table for sale for $250. Can you buy that for us?
Because we can't take the money.
And then that wouldn't go to our $39,577.
It would be easier on Caroline, that's for sure.
Okay. Know what?
So you're contributing to the town. They have to approve a contribution to the town.
So the town would have to approve someone donating the air hockey table?
Yes.
Even do the town have to approve them donating water and all that too?
No.
Is there a monetary limit in which the town has to approve it?
No.
So, how would we? I guess we'll cross that bridge when we get there if someone is donating something.
And who approves it? I've never approved anything. I'm going to cross that fourth wall. Vern?
But
approving an air hockey table as a donation?
It's a gift to the town.
Yeah,
it
we have to know
property.
About it.
And you and probably have to approve it. At $5,000, you have to have a public hearing on it.
Well, I don't expect any donations.
In aggregate,
if we ever did, yes.
My advice to you is don't count your chickens before they hatch.
Yes.
Don't worry about income.
I understand that.
Yeah.
But now we've come to another subject. we've been talking about donations for the last 3 months. Whom do we go to get the donations approved?
Your donations don't get approved. They're given to the town of Rawlinsburg for the rec program. And
right.
It is allocated towards the rec program.
So whether it's water or an air hockey table.
So if I want to bring every board game my own to the kids, I just have to let you know that I'm giving all this.
The camp director will just keep track of it. And at the end of the year, she'll just give us a list.
Kind of,
I had no
that's
idea
what
that
she
needed to happen.
So, and you know, I would not. I don't see anybody being like, hey.
So I mean,
we need to go look upstairs.
So even, so just to be clear, so we're collecting stuff now, collecting like 24 bags of water. So do we have to keep an inventory of all the items, even the waters and the snacks and stuff like that? Coming in? Is that true or?
It would be helpful because then you would just know your profit loss margin on your snack sales. That's just helpful for your snack sales more than anything.
It's not anything we need to provide to the town or the select board.
Ideally, if you want to micromanage that hard,
no.
Yes. What?
Any large donation.
Are you kidding me? We're thrilled that we just even know who's being hired.
Well, I also do understand that audits happen, too.
And audits do
so
happen,
I
and
make sure
where,
that we're hitting all the
right,
the
and that's where the we found out about the special account that wanted to be opened, and it had to go back into general fund, and our auditor came back and said, you need purchase orders for all this. They can't
okay.
have their separate account. You know. We're on the right track. If we step in another minefield, it won't be my first time. I'll take my
I guess maybe if we do get a bigger donation, that's probably something we should
yeah.
keep track.
Yeah, anything over $2,000, let us know.
Okay, so $2,000.
I hope I'll let you know a lot.
Or $1,000 or whatever. But yes. And I will bring it back to the board tomorrow night for
discussion. Where are we keeping all the donations that
well the basketballs and all that are
From there's. Bryant's donation, the Lutz Burgers brought them and gave them to Tia, and Tia gave them to the town, and they are upstairs right now. There's two boxes. There's
sporting equipment, mostly.
A couple of helmets, a couple of balls.
So you had like waters and granola bars or whatever. That's
yeah.
just keep put it there though.
The walkie-talkies are at my house.
Okay.
Oh, the boys are
on
the bus.
Of course, I
can
remember where I am.
You might want to go back to town hall.
And now, what about this line for the ice liner? Do they have that money, right?
There was a recommendation to put in that $1,100 for a new ice liner this year. So, if you guys would like to buy a new ice liner, that's there. That was not purchased in the 2017 budget.
It was it 16?
And if you bought it in 2016, there was no line item in the 2016 budget. There's no purchase order that came through for that line item. So it was not on town money. I don't know who bought it. So. So who bought it, Kathy?
Well, I think Tia and Sean bought it.
With their own money? Did they already buy it? Is it a new? They already have a new line?
Mm-hmm. It's not just like Home Depot plastic mm-hmm. sheeting?
No.
Oh.
It's a new one.
So,
well,
it's theirs. It's theirs if they would like to
buy. Well, if they purchased it in 2011, they would, that's too big for them.
2016. She asked for it.
2017.
Wow. She bought it, so she asked for the line item to be placed in her budget in October of 2016 for the 2017 budget. The 2017 budget does not start for January 1st. So if she bought it after January 1st, she can put in a purchase order. If the receipt says January 1st, then she can put in a purchase order.
We'll have to check in your bill.
Okay. If not, she either made a donation to the town, which is very kind of her,
or they will put her name on the poster.
Or she can choose to sell. Can she sell it to the town now?
I can't make that call.
All right, well, that was my thought. So,
But it sounds like we're better off just trying to get it changed.
Yes, next year. I would love to.
I'm not clear what she wants.
Well, you spend $500 a year to get the bouncy. Well, if we're going to do that, I think it needs a basketball court indoor first.
Outdoor?
No, indoor. I got a name, Wall Arena. Throwing all this out here.
Tennis, basketball.
Indoor, that's fine.
Well, I just didn't want any toes.
It's a lot more expensive.
Well. It wasn't coming out of my bank account.
One thing we do have to figure out, and bless my ass before, but just storage, you know.
Let's
figure that out.
Or the outside shed.
That's what
we need to construct a storage shed. That would be the first week project. Construct a storage shed for summer.
Yeah, the kids can paint all kinds of colors. Just give your boys a brush.
Didn't you see? Wasn't there a shed? Isn't there a shed on the school property they used last year for equipment?
Did you guys use that? Or were you allowed to use that?
The softball one, or wasn't there another one?
Can you answer on that?
Oh, there's one next door?
Yeah, but I can ask.
There's two of them. Two sheds now.
There's two?
What are you going to ask? I can get a actually, I think Kate will be at the meeting on Tuesday. I'm not going to ask her about that, so if it takes that off your plate, I don't want to do that.
Yep, I'll put that down.
Again, 65 is warm enough.
Oh, freezing.
Put on a sweater.
You got the ball rolling. This is where I kind of feel like the director can be like, unless we need to make the call.
Well, I think the part that we need to do for, we need to contact, there's a number for each one of these parks that you have to contact 2 weeks in advance to make sure that the date that we have picked is okay with them to bring in a busload of kids. So my thought is that probably the earlier the better, so maybe, I don't know, we could make, you know, even if we could do the first three, I mean, we start that fall.
And do they need the money ahead of time?
No,
we already sent the money, so all we need to do is figure out the date that we want to go, which for us will be a Tuesday. Right. So I'm sure they stagger their bus load.
So which
do you
want
me to call?
Did you talk about like Wall of Sands? Is that one of them?
Yeah. Well, we've been looking at a bunch of these that are
Wentworth State Park. Is that the top?
Something close.
I do not want them traveling like an hour on the bus.
Oh.
Something I'd rather not be at a lake than an ocean. I don't think there's a lot of lake parks. Is there?
Yeah. Where is Lake Whitmore?
Did we check with them?
It's about
Kingston State.
Just to see where, what day special ed?
My kids went on.
What day is what? About 45 minutes.
At the school, they have special ed. And so I was just wondering if anyone checked to make sure the field trips weren't on the same days.
I didn't know they had special ed in the school.
Yeah.
What, in the summer time?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
They
Tracy?
Jill Booten. There's quite a few teachers that go in for a couple hours in the mornings during the school summer.
Right.
And so I just wanted to make sure that those weren't like Tuesdays and Fridays.
Well, Fridays in the afternoon, our swim's in the afternoon,
yeah.
So that wouldn't affect it.
Yeah. But I have a contact person, it's Moira.
My boys have had reading in the past, but it almost seems like it's maybe
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, no, but they have like a set schedule.
Odeon is right there.
I know, but it's more like playground time center.
Right.
I don't think a lot of kids are going in.
Well, we went to that Newcastle Beach. I don't know if that's.
I mean, you know what? I don't think we all have to vote or decide. I would say just take a look through it, see what sounds the best, and get it rolling.
Yeah, those three, Lakeland, or the Tuckaway.
The Tuckaway is pretty close.
I did have a question off the subject that came to me earlier today. In the past, there have been kids in town that just showed up and hung out for the day.
Yeah, like,
I don't know. Ooh, I just know that kids did that. And can we do anything to prevent that? Because it's the school?
And it's the playground.
Oh, you mean they're coming just to play on the playground?
Yeah, and they come there, and they stay all day.
Oh, that's hard.
With
oh,
the
yeah.
kids, some of them even needing special medical attention and bringing that equipment with them. So is there,
so it's gonna be blocked off for.
So can we, are we able to say, I'm sorry, this is being leased by this organization right now? You can't, okay, good.
Like if the basketball team is having a game.
We can't go play.
Men's league comes in and goes, I'm here.
Right, well that's kind of what I assumed. But last year and in years past, they just said, okay. And they were there.
Should be assigned campers only, like campers and staff.
Perfect.
Yeah, that's why you're gonna have your camp rally.
I was gonna say, right off camp rally.
Yeah.
So we do need to have some sort of couple campers only sign or something.
It'll be helpful.
But if parents show up with like under six to play on the playground, you can't be like.
Well, yeah, because we are renting that facility right now.
Yeah.
Like she said, if someone shows up for a 6-year-old to shoot around, and you're using the basketball court for a game, they can't run out on the court and just start shooting around.
Yeah, a little kid. I mean, the
hours of 8 and 4 is Camp Raleigh.
Okay.
So I will double check with the board, but my interpretation is we are using that space.
Okay.
But
maybe
I'll double check with the board.
After 4 for the post-camp time, if there's less kids there, it'll be easier to manage, right? If we just say between 8 and 4, because technically it's between until 5, right?
Just saying somebody wanted to come play on the playground.
Yeah, there's only
6
kids there at that point, so there wouldn't be any games or anything scheduled.
I don't know, I think it's
8
to 5, so 8 to 5 it is.
Yeah.
You need to empower the staff, too.
Then they're going to be like, well, you guys were open at 4 o'clock and you let me come play. Why won't you let me come play at 2? You know, so I think we can't be arbitrary. We're using it from here to here.
Yeah.
That's how I interpret it, but I bring it back to the board.
There are other playgrounds.
Talk about pickups for the kids.
Your
parents.
Okay.
I
was strongly about this.
The board agreed that if you have a 15, 16-year-old that is on the list, they can pick up their siblings. But they are not walking themselves, and they are not checking themselves out. They're adamant about that this year.
I'm sorry.
So if you have the 15, 16-year-old siblings can pick up their, if they're on the list.
They have to be on the list.
So the youngest is 15.
Here's a question that my wife raised, actually, regarding the drop-off pickup. What happens if two kids who are friends in the program, one mom wants to come, she's coming to my house after the rec program?
Just like everything else, you're going to be notifying the camp counselors that day.
When you do the drop-off, you have
right,
to advise them.
Like,
so it's going to be taking.
I'll use my daughter as an example. Her best friend is Laura Jean, and Zoe is going to be I have to call. Zoe's going to be being picked up, or in writing that morning, Zoe's going to be being picked up by Laura Jean's mommy, and they're going to go, and then Laura Jean's mommy's going to come up. So
we're cool with that. As long as the parent is
on the
morning,
list, then you can add to your
call
list.
So we read
calls.
Notes, right?
But
it's on a note with permission.
A call will know something?
I mean, there's only like two of my friends that I would say that would pick up my child. I have some friends, but I mean, if you know that your kids,
I have like four.
So like, I could list all of them.
I mean, you could list all of Rawlsford on your list if you wanted, I guess.
Right. I could. But I'm saying most people are going to be on. I'm going to put them on the list. It's true. So I mean, you could put on our list. We could, there's a person, you know, like my daughter's friend Leah. You could list, you could put 10 to 6 pages.
I mean, the poor counselor that has to go through and find. Sorry, I just remembered that question.
Yeah.
I wanted to make sure I.
But yeah, just remember, you guys are moving all in the right direction, and you know we are going to have questions as time goes on, and we're every day we're going to be like, oh, did we go over this? It's going to happen, but you guys are so moving in the right direction. This is going to be amazing.
It's a million times better than it was. So.
Yeah.
Do we have anything else on the agenda?
I don't believe so.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
anybody want to bring anything else up?
I did a survey for my 7:30.
Yes.
Did you see that?
I did.
Did you see that? It's
so
not just me.
how would we be able to do that? Because that's going to add cost.
Would you want an extra half an hour drop off?
Try it.
Why don't we just round it off and call it 6 a.m.?
That would be great. I would totally agree.
She wants her application back.
It doesn't have to happen, but, you know.
Definitely a food for that. I mean, a lot of camps start at 7:30.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
And we got like 14 kids that said yes, because you have my two, you have Megan's two. He had another family that has four, so.
Wow.
Just saying.
See, but here's my
you need a
that would
program,
be another dollar.
I need early school.
But here's my question and my problem going back to 395.77. Now we decide to open half an hour earlier.
Right.
Our income is going to be more. Our expenses are going to be more, but we're now going to be above the 395.77. I'd love to do that, but I'm sorry, ma'am. You're going to have to figure out something else for your children. And I can't go above my lot.
I'm sorry.
Hold on, we're recording. No, I mean, I like your idea, but all joking aside.
No, yeah.
Now we're, I don't think we can promise that until we can find out if we can get the job, whatever it was from UNH, work study.
Right.
Because then we.
To the start, we'll know more about.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but we definitely can't publicize something like that. I got
to talk to your 14.
Manage to the number list. Or,
well, I'll send them the boys out.
Yeah.
I've been trying for 2 years. You know how much money you can make if you started from 7 to 9 and then brought the kids to work with you? No, she wants to feed asleep.
Mm. Sleep is important for her.
You'd have a ton of kids at your house.
But you know what? Then when she wants to go to Aroma Joe's and needs $9 for an Aroma Joe, how they get away from that, I don't know. She'd have the money.
That means you get a double.
Or she buys a friend one too.
Oh, you mean they don't cost $9? But Ivan, I think it's a great idea, but you just gotta wait.
No, I know.
Should I call some state parks or are you guys going to go?
I have a list.
Okay.
So there's actually a person that's listed on that list for each park.
Okay.
So if I find that, I could forward it to you.
Yeah, I can make some calls.
What's the list?
New Hampshire State Park.
Okay.
I don't think anybody has it, but
I've seen it.
Oh, really?
I remember seeing it.
Did I print it out for you in the letter? You like this?
Yeah,
place?
I was tiny.
Yeah.
Oh, you can forward it to me if you're me.
Well, we'll have to figure out which where we're going first. That we need to
well, we have all right, three, so
our,
four now.
April 9th is the next one.
Our next meeting, right, is April 9th.
Should be able to be back by 7.
Okay.
If there's an issue, I'll let you know. But I'm pretty sure.
How are you going?
Vermont, so.
You're not allowed to leave town.
Sorry. You can't.
You
got until August 18th.
Tell you what, I'll make a deal. I won't leave town if you give me more than 39.5 cents.
Hey, you could have stood up at town meeting and said, I want more. No one did it.
Wow.
It's all
hey,
done.
I didn't know we could do that.
Did you not see the people?
But you wait, at town meeting you can ask for just one line to be increased.
I had to sit through 6 hours of that. I'm not answering that any longer.
Well, I mean, that's true. I guess every yeah. everything was a line on the overall.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, all right. Dumb question, I apologize.
Yes. You could just ask for the bottom line to be increased by whatever, and then there would be a vote on it, just like there was. Somebody asked to for the baseline item to be increased by whatever it was, and then there was a vote on it, yes. So you could have stood back up. Like I wanted dental for the police. I could have stood up and said, I want to add 5,000 into the 1.7, whatever it is. And then there would be a vote on it.
Would you have to say why?
I can tell them why I want it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But it would just be a bottom line increase.
Wait a minute, so I could stand there and say I want a bottom line increase of 5,000 and then the town then decides if they want it then, instead of giving it to the rec, they would,
Select board has the authority to move on items as long as it doesn't have to do with your school or the library. They are trustees.
Can you show the notes for me?
If we do end up with 45 cap, we could potentially then bat our eyes and nicely talk to you and give that 5,000 back. Never mind, I'm going to let it all go.
Why don't you worry about your budget first? The money has to come in.
So do we have anything else going on?
No, I don't think so. So we have our...
Organizational workshop.
Yay.
Okay. Okay.